Hello everyone. In this demo, we're going to explore ways to protect access to your Linux servers and why that's critically important for businesses of all sizes and in all industries. Here's our agenda. We're going to kick it off by talking about why the IT Linux estate is a major cause for concern. Then we'll look at the main risks that you'll be facing as a result of this gap in security and how taking the next step in PAM maturity is going to drive down those risks. During this conversation, we're going to look at Delinea's Server Suite and the capabilities it offers to address these challenges. So let's kick things off with some basic facts. Cyberattacks are a growing priority in the boardroom. We're all hypersensitive to this. It's all around us in the press and in analyst reports, like the annual Verizon Data Breach Investigation Report. Those of you watching this have likely experienced an incident or a breach in the last 12 months. So ransomware is still top of mind for most, and cybersecurity insurers are raising the bar, demanding things like MFA to protect data on servers and help prevent those ransomware attacks. While cyberattacker playbooks can vary tremendously in the tactics and techniques they use, compromising privileged accounts remains a priority to gain access to servers and get to the crown jewels, your sensitive data, to exfiltrate or encrypt it for ransom, or both, in double extortion attacks. So let's focus on your servers, specifically Linux and Unix. Why Linux and Unix? Well, the Windows team has the relative luxury of a platform to help centrally manage permissions and access in their Windows estate. We know this, it's called Active Directory. But the Linux team has no such platform, and so securing access to Linux servers is more of a concern for organizations, and it has lots of challenges. And some of the main ones we see here on the screen. So the million-dollar question is, how do we address them? Must we rely on the native tools, or is there an alternative? Privileged access management can help. Now, most of you will be at phase one of your PAM maturity journey with a password vault to protect access to privileged accounts, such as root. Hopefully, you'll be using Delinea Secret Server for that. Making your Linux servers more resilient to cyber attacks means evolving to the next stage of PAM maturity with a privilege elevation solution, such as Delinea Server Suite. So let's look at how Server Suite can help mitigate those challenges and risks that we met earlier. So the first two challenges around routine use of root and too many privileged accounts. This relates to the attack surface. We all know the local superuser account, root, has standing privileges, and it gives a user or an adversary unfettered access. So this represents a huge risk on all our Linux and Unix servers. But beyond this, it's typical for administrators to create individual local privileged accounts. Here's a typical Linux box, and if we look at the local accounts in etcpassword, you can see at the bottom, there's several created by our Linux team admins. Now, each one of these is a potential vector of attack, increasing your attack surface. Note that most of these are also members of the wheel group. And if we search for the wheel group in the etcsudoers file, you can see that all members of the wheel group can run any command as root using sudo. And this is very typical. If any of those accounts are compromised, then the attacker has full rights. Now, this is just one Linux system. Every system is a silo of identities. You may have 50, 100, or even thousands of Unix and Linux systems. If these local privileged accounts are also present on these boxes, probably with the same passwords across each one, then the adversary can now move laterally. Now, the simple remedy for this is identity consolidation. First, we vault the local root accounts in Delinea's Secret Server. You're likely already doing that. But instead of allowing admins to check these out routinely, they stay locked away for emergency break glass use only, not for routine daily use. We then eliminate these local privileged accounts. We take them off the playing field. Admins now have one account. It's their Enterprise AD account instead of lots of local privileged accounts on different systems, thereby reducing the attack surface and applying the best practice of zero standing privileges. Moving on to the next challenge around full privilege. Well, in response, we follow zero trust guidelines by removing implicit trust and enforcing least privilege at the server level. We ensure the administrator's AD accounts have minimum rights. But that begs the question, how do they do their jobs with no admin rights? Well, we enable them to log into Linux and Unix with their AD account instead of those local privileged accounts, which we've eliminated. I'm going to log in here as Zach Admin using his AD account. Now, you may be thinking that Linux and Unix know nothing about AD accounts. So we achieve this by joining the server to Active Directory. Here you see this machine is joined to the dc2.borderlands.com AD domain. It's part of that domain, just like a Windows server would be. Now, if I search for Zach Admin in the password file, you see he's not there. There's no local account. But if I look in AD Users and Computers, there he is. So Delinea Server Suite is the glue enabling AD-centric management of Linux and Unix server access using AD accounts for login. Now note that it's more than just querying AD. The Linux server is actually joined to the domain, so we can do so much more with that. Now once logged in, to execute privilege commands, the admins must be assigned specific PAM privilege elevation roles. As you see here, I can't edit the sudoers file, but I've been granted a role that allows me to do this, so I can elevate. And voila. Now a key concept here is just enough privilege, i.e. the admin only gets elevated rights to perform that specific task and nothing more. Now for this demo, the PAM role was pre-assigned. However, for just-in-time access, we don't pre-assign roles, but we enable the user to request them just in time. The request is routed via workflow to approvers. If approved, these roles are automatically provisioned for a limited time and then automatically deprovisioned to avoid standing privileges. Now the next challenge in our list is distributed rights management on each Linux box via local etc sudoers files. As we just saw, we joined the service to AD, so now instead of the overhead of logging into each Linux box and managing rights locally in each sudoers file, we can centrally manage our PAM policies in AD for all systems, controlling user login, privilege elevation, MFA, as well as local session recording. Create your roles, rights, and role assignments in Delinea zones for local enforcement on the Linux and Unix servers. Now, since the native AD container model is limited, Delinea Server Suite provides a hierarchical zone model to make it much easier to do role management. Since roles are inherited through nested child zones, role management is simplified, avoiding role replication and toxic combinations. You can structure your zones to best match your governance model. For example, access and privilege management aligned to each department, each geographic location, or regulatory requirements such as a zone dedicated to PCI servers that require more stringent access control treatment, or a combination. Now the next challenge on the list is similar. Event logs are distributed on each server. So for instant investigation or compliance reporting, that's a big resource sink. You can push them to a syslog server, but the challenge remains that the logs are cryptic and they're interleaved with many other events that complicate and slow down forensic analysis. Server Suite focuses on privileged access activity only and locally captures detailed events at the process level on each server. And these are forwarded to an aggregator that correlates events into sessions for reporting on who has access to what and who did what, where and when, using built-in reports. Or you can do ad hoc queries against any of the event metadata. There's also session recording. Since this is done on the host versus a proxy, you won't lose visibility if that proxy is circumvented. And you get a lot more metadata. You can use this metadata to search for commands within the session video and jump straight to that index to speed up forensic analysis. Okay, the final challenge in our list that I wanted to cover. For many regulations where high-risk users and servers are in scope, such as PCI DSS and GDPR, access controls at the server level are a requirement. Similarly, cybersecurity insurers are demanding MFA at the server as well. Server Suite can enforce MFA policies at login and during elevation, supporting all major authenticators, including FIDO2 and passkeys. These MFA policies are centrally managed at the zone level. So here you see MFA enabled for login, and here you see step-up authentication being enabled when executing this specific command. So to summarize, Delinea Server Suite complements Secret Server by ensuring resilience at the Linux and the Unix server level. It reduces the attack surface through identity consolidation, eliminating silos of identities on each server, and removing routine use of root and administrative group membership. Least privilege is enforced with admins logging into Linux and Unix systems with their enterprise AD account. All access, elevation, and MFA policies are now centrally managed in AD by joining each server to the AD domain and leveraging Delinea's patented zone technology for role governance. Capturing host-level privileged activity is granular and consolidated for centralized reporting and visual session review. Compliance and cyber insurance requirements are more easily met with server-level security controls, including MFA on server login and on privilege elevation. Thanks very much indeed for watching this video. For more information about Delinea Server Suite, please visit our website.